Don't use boring bullet points in your presentations. Instead, include these stunning infographic designs to uplift your presentations. These designs not only make your slide look professional, but also make them more dynamic and engaging. So hello everyone, welcome to another PowerPoint tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how to create these professional infographic designs step by step. Plus, I've got a surprise for you, so make sure to watch till the end. Now let's get started. To create such infographics, we will need a gear icon. So go to Insert tab, Icons, then search for the gear icon. Now I would like to customize this icon to increase the number of spikes and adjust the hollow space in between, which is not possible directly with this icon. So let's do it other way. Insert a star shape with 10 points and a circle. Adjust the angle of the spikes and place the circle in the middle of the star. Slightly increase the size of circle. Now select both the shape, go to merge shape and choose the intersect option to remove the sharp corners. Next, add another circle, place it in the middle and slightly increase its size to give it a gear-like appearance. Now select both shapes, go to merge shape and choose union. Finally, to create a hollow effect, add one more circle, adjust its size and place it in the center. Select both shapes, go to merge shape and choose subtract. Now remove the outline and there you have it, your custom gear icon. Now increase the size and place it on the left. Duplicate it to create three more. Now select all, go to shape format, align and choose distribute horizontally to align them evenly. Next, group all of them, make it center aligned and then ungroup it again. Next, insert an arc shape and to make sure it properly aligns with the gear, stretch the arc to create a circle and then select both the shape and make it center and middle aligned. Next, adjust the arc to cover only the upper portion of the gear. Then go to shape outline, increase its outline weight. Also add an arrow at the edge of the arc. Let me slightly adjust the weight and the corners. Perfect. Now duplicate the arc to cover other gears. For the second gear, flip the arc vertically and duplicate it for the fourth gear. Now bring the icons into the middle of each gear. You may customize or replace the icon based on your needs. Now it's time to add text. Insert a text box for the subheading, align the text to the center, make it bold and set the font size to 16. Duplicate the text box for the description. I will add a sample text and then group both the text boxes. Now before moving further, let's slightly decrease the size of all the shapes and icon. For that, group all of them, resize and then ungroup it again. Next, select the text box and place it at the top of first gear. Duplicate it for remaining gear. For the second and fourth gear, place it at the bottom. Let's slightly adjust the position. Next, let's add color to the design. For the arc, choose a light shade of blue. Do the same for gear and icons. And for the second and fourth portion, use black color. Now let's add animation effect. Select the first gear, go to animation tab and apply the zoom effect. Again, go to add animation and apply a spin effect. Now in the animation pane, double click the effect to open its settings, switch to the timing tab and set the duration to 5 seconds and in repeat, select until end of the slide. Next, apply fade effect to the icon. For the arc, choose wipe effect and change the effect option to the left. For the text box, choose zoom effect. Now in the animation pane, rearrange the animation sequence. Place the icon animation at second. Set all effect to start after previous except the arc. For the arc, select start on click. Now use the animation painter tool to replicate these animation for the second gear. Make sure to rearrange the timings in the animation pane. Also change the spin direction to counterclockwise for a more realistic look. Then replicate the animation to the third one and then to the fourth one. And we are done. Let's preview the slide. Moving on, for the second slide, we will start by copying the gear icon from the previous slide. Then remove its animation. Go to Insert tab. Insert a hollow circle and place it in the middle. Adjust its thickness. Then insert a rectangle. Select both the shapes and make them center and middle align. Adjust the thickness. Then duplicate it to create three more rectangles. And align all of them to the left and top. Now rotate each rectangles. Rotate the first one to 90 degrees, second one to 45 degrees, and the third one to minus 45 degrees. And there we have a wheel-like structure. Now select all the shapes, go to Shape Format, Merge Shape, and choose Fragment to split them into pieces. Now select these outer pieces, then duplicate it and delete the rest. Then group all these pieces and make it center align. Place the gear in the middle. Now select all, increase the size and reposition it. Next, select these bottom pieces and delete them. Now insert a hollow circle, place it in the middle of the gear, adjust its size and thickness. Finally, insert one more circle and place it in the middle. Now select all shapes with outline and remove their outlines. Next, let's add color to the slide. I will choose shades of gray for the gear and inner circles. For the outer pieces, I will pick shades of blue from the color palette. And perfect. Now for the text, I will add sample text. Make sure to adjust the alignment properly. Next, select these icons and place them in the middle of these circular pieces. Also change the color of icons to white. Now for subheadings, increase the font size, match the color with respective pieces and use uppercase. Do the same for other. Next, insert an arrow shape and adjust its size. Change the color to black and increase its thickness. Now duplicate the arrow and flip it vertically, then reposition it. Repeat the same process for remaining two. Now let's animate the slide. Select the gear and inner circle and apply the zoom effect. Again, add a spin effect to the gear. Next, adjust the spin setting. Set the duration to 20 seconds. And in repeat, select until end of this line. Now rearrange the effect in the animation pane. Place the animation of inner circle at the third position. Right click on first effect and set it to start on click. For the next two, choose start after previous. And the spin animation should start with previous. Next, animate the circular pieces. Select the first circular piece and apply the zoom effect. For the icon, select the fade effect and apply the wipe effect to the arrow and change the effect option to the right. Finally, for the text box, choose the zoom effect. Now, use the animation painter tool to replicate these effects for the other pieces. In the third portion, change the wipe effect direction to the left. Now replicate the animation to the fourth piece. And we are done. Now let's preview both the slides. So that's it for this video. We will cover more designs in the upcoming video. And now for the surprise I mentioned at the beginning, I am giving away this PowerPoint template along with some additional infographic designs to help you create stunning presentations with ease. To get your copy, simply like this video, subscribe to the channel and drop a comment below with your email ID and I'll send it straight to your inbox. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for more such amazing content. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.